So this is a big moment. I'm going to meet now the leader of Podemos himself, Pablo Iglesias, the ponytailed former political professor whose party has transformed Spanish politics, a party only founded less than 2 years ago. So what we're going to do is we're going to meet him in Murcia and we're going to join him on his campaign bus to Valencia. Spent years now, I know, preparing. Podemos is less than 2 years old, but you're a long-time activist, political professor. To be now, at this moment, at the centre of Spanish politics, with all your friends, activists, comrades here, how does that feel? It must be a strange feeling.
Well, it's a very special feel. It's some kind of historical spirit that is around the air, and I feel that I'm doing with many people, with my comrades, but also with much people in Spain, something very, very important for our country. We see that we are in front of the door of a new political era, a new political period in Spain. We know that the situation is quite difficult, and even if we win the elections, the power you have in the states is not so big. To win the election is not to get the power, and we understood very well what happened in Greece and what happened in Europe. The correlation of force is the key element in order to imagine a different world. But at the same time, we are seeing in the experience in the city councils in Spain that even in the very small margins of the state, of the administration, it's possible to change many things. And the fact that this is more or less the expression of this upset from the 15M movement in Spain is something.
The so-called indignados, which kicks off.
Yeah. So I feel very excited.
Your family were persecuted by Franco's dictatorship. That must have had a big political influence on your ideas.
For me, that's very important. I'm obviously a leftist, in not just for my ideology, but also for my life and the history of my family. But at the same time, I think we are creating something new, something where the DNA of the fights in Spain for freedom and the fights of the working class organization in Spain can be recognized. But at the same time, many people with different cultural experience, not just political tradition, but cultural experience in other worlds, are joining us in this experience of change.
Podemos, when it was founded less than 2 years ago, had an unprecedented rise.
Yeah.
I don't think in a post-war Western Europe you've had such a party come from nowhere and go to leading the polls. Before the remontada, the so-called comeback during this election campaign, Podemos went sharply down. Why do you think that happened?
I think that the polls are the polls, and usually are very conservative with us. At the same time, we analyzed at the beginning that our country was in a regime crisis or an organic crisis, if you want to use the Gramscian terms. This kind of political situation is very volatile, very open, with many possibilities. So the political change in this year are unbelievable. It was very difficult to imagine that Manuela Carmena, for instance, could be the mayor of Madrid or the victory of Ada Colau. So the instability, the political instability, is one of the main features, the main characteristics of this political period. That's the reason, because we have to be very, very strategic in order to play the game of discourses and the game of campaigns. We always say that we are very good in campaigns because we can understand the ideological movements of the society in order to play the game and to get the possibilities. At the same time, I think that Podemos has been always very, very strong, but the attacks in the media against us obviously were a problem for us.
There's a quote sometimes given to Albert Einstein, which is the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. And the old left, if you like, so-called, you could put that accusation against them, that if we just
wave our flags a bit more and say socialism a bit more. Yeah. And you've rejected that, haven't you? And do you think that's why you've succeeded in the way you have your new formula?
Probably because I'm a leftist and I have a very strong experience in the left and in the radical left, and this is the experience of many of the members of my family. I don't want to lose, and I saw that sometimes it's very comfortable to be a leftist with your flag, with your discourse, and with this aesthetic victory of the loser, and sometimes that is very useful for the establishment. You know, the establishment, the enemy, want us in this position where you are not able to win. And probably if you want to win, you need to speak another language. You need to understand that the left was beaten in our countries, and especially in Spain. So in many cases, the cultural elements in order to create a social majority are not the cultural elements of the left. Probably the most of the people in Spain don't cry with the same songs I do. And probably they don't feel the same things with, for instance, the international or the red flag than I feel. And I feel that because that's my tradition. But if you want to do politics and you want to understand that the social right, the social justice and the democratization of the economy is the main goal, probably you need to be not very religious regarding the symbols of the left.
You said you thought Podemos, you think mistakes have been made. What mistakes do you think you made and learned from them?
I think the big mistake was the intonation, and that was probably my personal mistake. I think I have been very, very angry sometimes, and this is probably a leftist tradition, to be angry, and when you believe that if you show you're angry, you are more effective or more clear. And I learned from Manuela Carmena, from Ada Colau, that if you explain the things clearly, but at the same time smiling and in a different way, you can be understood in a better way. And I think that sometimes it was very clear that the situation was very difficult for us. We had to run very fast and at the same time dressing ourselves. So probably we commit many communication mistakes, and sometimes probably we have not the best attitude.
As a British person, I've learned from bitter experience not always to trust opinion polls.
Okay.
However, it does seem in the last few days, a bit longer than that, that there has been a so-called remontada, which crowds chanted here so enthusiastically, a comeback in English, of course. How do you explain it? Why do you think Podemos has started to claw back so successfully the ground it lost?
I think that the debates in television were very useful for us. I think we have the opportunity to speak directly to the people. We are very, very effective. The campaign shows that possibility, and that's the reason, because the campaigns are good for us. We have not the same space and the same possibilities respect the other political actors, but the game, the match is more equal in campaigns. At the same time, I think that we have been very, very effective in the strategy of communication, and probably the other political actors had been, how could I say, not very intelligent. I think the situation now of Ciudadanos is terrible, because they have had many problems. The more important party, in order to understand the Spanish political system, is the Socialist Spanish Party, and I think that they have a problem to a contradiction between the things they say in the campaigns and the things they do when they have the government, and I think they have a crisis of credibility, and their candidate Pedro Sánchez probably has not a personality to be a person that is believed by people.
He seems like he's been grown in a laboratory to become a politician. As an outsider, it's almost like he's like the archetypal politician.
Yeah, and I think that's a problem for him in a moment like this. Probably in other historical moment, this kind of perfect man, very handsome and very very classical, could be useful. But I think in a moment like this, even for the Socialist Party, was needed something more real, more like the people.
So, as you say, the Social Democratic Party here is PSOE, and they were in power, of course, when the crash happened. Began cuts, which helped destroy, they attacked their supporters, lost a lot of support as a consequence. What's your attitude, Podemos, as a party towards PSOE?
We can have agreements with the PSOE when we are in a better position respect them. And the best example is the City Council of Madrid and Cádiz. If we are more powerful than them, they have to choose between the right or us. And I think in that kind of situation, they can be more or less social democrats. That is something almost revolutionary in a moment like this, just to say, okay, the welfare state is something good, and to spend money and to do a fiscal reform more progressive. When they have power, when they are the second or the first party, we know very well what the Socialist Party do, and I think in this way it's not very different respect the Labour Party in Great Britain. Unfortunately, the third way of Tony Blair and the style of Gerhard Schroeder was assumed too by the Spanish Socialist Party. I think the Social Democrats in Europe are now in a very big crisis, because probably the best consequence, the more clear consequence after the financial crisis was this small space in order to do politics for the social democrat traditions in Europe. I have said many times that we are occupying, we are taking the political space of social democrats, and probably our political program is a social democrat program. It's not an ideological element, but probably the space where we can be in a moment like this. I think even the Greece government is doing, obviously with a different style and with another tradition, what was expected or what was supposed to be done by the PASOK in Greece. Now I think that there is also a crisis in the Partito Democratico in Italy, where they understand that, for instance, regarding the deficit, in the public finances is something that have to change in order to have possibilities to help the people.
I started this year in Athens when Syriza were elected with a huge victory, and I remember the cheering in the streets, the jubilation, and I remember what happened to them. The European Union leaders crushed Syriza to set an example, partly because of Spain, and Donald Tusk, the president of the European Council, said they weren't scared of financial contagion from Greece, they were scared of political contagion. Because if Syriza succeeded and were seen to succeed, that would be a boost for Podemos. And why would it be different? Why would it be different for Spain?
Because we are the fourth economy in the Eurozone, and the situation, the economic situation in Spain is different. And at the same time, I think that probably we will have more capacity of negotiation in the frame of European Union. Obviously, it's not going to be easy, but I think that the change in Europe is something very clear. Not necessarily in a good way. For instance, in France, the situation is terrible. But the success of Jeremy Corbyn in the Labour Party, what is happening in Ireland with Sinn Féin, the situation now in Portugal is changing. I think even in Italy, more or less, Matteo Renzi is saying that it's possible to do the things in another way. I'm sure if we finally have the possibility of rule the government in Spain, the situation in the European Union is going to be different. Greece, unfortunately, is a very small country with a very difficult internal situation, and probably we will have more possibilities.
There was a video today of Angela Merkel being told by your Prime Minister, Rajoy, that Podemos might come second. She didn't look happy at all. What would it mean, do you think, because the German government is very dominant within the Eurozone and was the driving force behind the treatment of Greece. What do you think Podemos doing well would mean for that situation in Europe?
It's going to be different, because probably Angela Merkel is very happy with some kind of colonial president. He's not a president, he's just the man of Angela Merkel in Spain. Probably with a real president who is able to negotiate in a different way, she's not going to be happy. I understand very well that it's difficult to negotiate with the German government, and it's difficult to change the correlation of forces in the Eurogroup. But politics is that, and many countries in Europe, and also France and Italy, have the interest of negotiate with Germany in another way. I know that the margin of the capacity we will have is very limited. I understand that the geopolitical issues are so big. But Spain is the fourth economy in the Eurogroup, and we have a position of negotiation very strong in order to even to have a good relation with the German government.
And the Citizens Movement Party, which you spoke about, a centre-right party with lots of right-wing, leading candidates have called for banning the burqa in Catalonia, very often reactionary statements on the right to abortion, on domestic violence. But how do you explain, what are the Citizens Party, and are you threatened by them? Do you feel threatened as a party by them?
It has been a very interesting political expression. I remember the owner of a Spanish bank, the Bank of Sabadell, he said we need a right-wing Podemos. And probably that was the prophecy of the success of Ciudadanos. Ciudadanos is not a right-wing or a left-wing party. It's a party of the power. It's an establishment party. If the establishment is in a more social democrat way, they are comfortable with that. And if the establishment said another thing, they are comfortable too. They are very, especially the leader, Albert Rivera, he's a great communicator. He's very intelligent in order to create a political discourse. But I think that everybody understands here, even the voters of Ciudadanos, that is a party very close to the big economical powers in Spain. And obviously in a moment of crisis like this, they are not very, very new, because they started more than 10 years ago in Catalonia, but they are a new party in Spain. And in a political moment like this, a new party without many cases of corruption inside, without past, and with a young leader, very intelligent and a very good communicator in television, obviously in a moment like this, they will have a great outcome in the election. I think they are going to be the fourth force in the elections, but it's a very interesting political phenomenon.
Women have played a big role in the Podemos and its allies in the social movements, and we've seen Ada Colau elected mayor of Barcelona, who's prominent in the anti-eviction movement. We've seen Manuela Carmena, in Madrid.
Yeah.
How important is that, this kind of feminist dimension of what's happening?
I think that is very important, and probably they are giving us the future of politics. I know Ada Colau from almost 15 years ago. We were activists in the anti-globalization movement in those days, and she's a leader of a different political generation, where women have a very different political rule, even regarding the traditions of the old left in our country. Manuela is another history. She's an older person, a very famous judge, progressist judge in Spain. And probably because she has this special profile, she was able to win the election in Madrid. Madrid is a more conservative city, respect Barcelona. And probably because we could support Carmena, Carmena had things that we had not. Probably she was the best complement. How could I explain? Carmena had all the support of Podemos, but at the same time, many socialist voters, many even more conservative voters, believe it that an old person like her, with great experience, with a great preparation, was the best person in order to be the mayor, and I'm very happy, and I'm very happy too with the protagonism of women in politics, and especially in the left. Unfortunately, left has had almost always men leaders.
You're less than 2 years old, Podemos. Some would say, are you ready for government?
I think so. I think that we can take the government. We have the experience of city councils, and we think we are more prepared than the other political actors. Obviously, it's going to be very difficult, but we assume the challenge.
And finally, what do you think of Jeremy Corbyn? And if you had a message for people in Britain who are stuck with a Conservative government now till 2020, people are often quite desperate about politics, they're fearful about the future. What would you say to them to give them hope?
I would say to them that politics is a cluster of tools that sometimes allows people to improve the conditions of life. Politics is very important to left politics, to the politicians. And I think that Jeremy Corbyn is probably the best historical expression of the good labor tradition in Great Britain. And I think that with a man like him in the government in Great Britain, the British working class could retake the proud and what they had in the past as a referent for all the workers in the world.
Great, cheers, Pablo. That was great, fantastic. Cheers, Owen.
I'm sorry for my English.
No, it's brilliant.
I don't have
very
many
clear
chances to practice
no,
now.
No. Well, that was it was a lot better than my Spanish.